your girl Sid. I am back with another video. This time I am parked. I'm not moving. I'm right in front of, right near my son's school. But before I get out, I wanted to talk about something that was addressed yesterday in church. And then as I was listening to Pastor Darius Daniel's sermon from yesterday, I'm not the same. I had dealt with some things in the spirit yesterday that I did not know that I was dealing with, but the Lord will show you your blind spots when you're willing and surrendered. So today I want to talk about unaddressed brokenness. For many of you already know, if you have been following my channel for a little bit, whether on TikTok or YouTube, I've shared a little bit about what took place back in October of last year, which I had a miscarriage around that time. And the thing about it is, I thought that, you know, I got over it. I thought I was resilient. I thought I bounced back. I thought everything was all good, gravy. My belief was still strong. Like, I just thought everything was good. And I shared a little bit about this on my TikTok yesterday, but I wanted to go a little deeper here on my YouTube channel because Pastor Darius Daniels today was talking about unaddressed brokenness and how that can alter how we believe or even blind us into believing that we're still believing God for miracle signs and wonders to happen in our lives when we're really not. We're really jaded. And what the Lord revealed to me yesterday is that I had a resentment towards him about what happened, what had taken place. And I noticed it because my time of the month started yesterday. And when it, as it was leading up to it, I had like this anger. Like, I don't know what it was, but that thing has always kind of been there around it because of the fact that I had been trying to have children since having Josiah. I had been trying to have another child and hadn't happened. And then when that happened, because I was still worshiping, I was still praising, I was still standing and believing God for the impossible. Even in the hospital bed, I was still declaring and speaking the word over my body through tears, even through the doctor coming in and confirming what was taking place in my body. I was still just holding on to every ounce of faith that I had. And I didn't think that my faith had been taken away or shaken or anything like that. But the Lord revealed to me yesterday that I had resented him for it, or had these feelings of resentment and disgust and anger. And a lot of those feelings showed itself this week. It's funny how what we think is hidden, or we think it's not there because we're so accustomed to feeling those things. My pastor described it yesterday as a stronghold. And what strongholds are like, they're like caves with a like this large boulder in front of it, a place for people to hide or things to hide. Help me, Holy Spirit. But what I really want to address, like I said, is just how I didn't even know that existed. I didn't even know that was a problem. I didn't know it was an issue. I just thought that I was good. Like, I was still believing. But we don't realize that the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy. And sometimes we focus so much, or the enemy trying to take me out, he's trying to take me out, he's trying to take me out. But sometimes the things that he does is little by little, and sometimes they're so little that you miss them. If you're not careful, you miss that something has been sniped. He is at a distance and he is taking you out one by one by one by one. He's taking out your faith. He's taking out your hope. He's taking out your strength little by little. It's not always something so grand, or, you know, the enemy, he's conniving. He's sneaky. He doesn't want you to always know that he's there. He blends in with your day-to-day life. He's not evident all the time. And I, like I said, I thought I was in a place where I was okay. I thought I was in a place where I was good. And I want to share this dream. And then I shared a little bit of this on TikTok the night that, or a few days after I had taken the positive pregnancy test, maybe 2 or 3 days after, or a day, maybe a day. It wasn't long. It may be a day or two after I had taken the positive pregnancy test. I had a dream. I had a dream that I was bleeding a lot. I mean, bleeding so much. And I just remember I was sitting on the toilet in the dream and I was bleeding a lot. And something happened. in that dream. Something was either planted or stolen, I feel. I'm not 100% sure, but I do believe that the enemy does try to work and manipulate his way in through sometimes through our dreams in the realm of the spirit. And so I believed in that moment something was robbed, though I did not see it or take heed to it or any of that. I just know that the Lord put a spotlight on the places that were dark. And if you allow him to, he will shine a light on the darkest places that you think are so, that are healed or you think you've gotten over. I'm like, Lord, I thought I was over this. I was still standing and believing for children. Still, I'm still standing and believing that it will take place. But the thing about resentment, it will have you not even wanting to pray about the very thing that you used to believe in. And it could even be that maybe something didn't happen when you expected it to, so your faith was shaken. You're like, I expected this to happen by now. I thought this was going to happen by now. Or something happened that the Lord promised you and it didn't happen the way that you thought it was. So now you have this resentment or this brokenness, this place of brokenness between you and God. You feel like your communication was off. You feel like you heard him wrong. And resentment begins to grow off of that because we're like, Lord, you know, I trusted you. I put my all into this. I really leaned in. I really thought that this was going to take place. And then when it doesn't, it shakes our faith and it leads us to a place where we feel as though we can't trust God anymore, or we don't. We still trust him. The thing about it is, unresolved brokenness will still have you operating in the motions of being a follower of Christ, which of course my worship was still authentic. My praise was still authentic. Everything was still real. But when you're believing for certain levels, because where I am believing now and the level of faith that I need, thank you, Holy Spirit, the level of faith that I need for the next and for what I'm believing God for cannot have any brokenness or doubt attached to it. There needs to be a certain level of faith. In the word, it says we go from faith to faith, from glory to glory. And if you have these things that are unaddressed, God can only meet you or give things to you at your level of faith. But if your level of faith is broken or shaken and you don't realize it, what he gives you can only be where you are. So before he gives you, oh, thank you, Holy Spirit, before he gives you something big, he wants to make sure that your faith will be able to withstand the very thing that you're believing for, because maybe it may take a little longer than expected, or maybe it's going to require a different version of you. But he has to fix the brokenness, because the brokenness cannot go with you into the next level. And I thank God that he exposed the hand of the enemy. I thank God that he exposed the resentment that I had towards him. And sometimes we don't even want to use certain words because we're like, oh, I don't resent God. I don't have these feelings towards God. And that's what I was thinking. I'm like, what? And the funny thing is, y'all, I was just reading in my finishing up Master Your Emotions, because I thought I finished it. Then I looked and I was at like 80%. I do that sometimes. I'd be like, oh, let me go to the next book. And I hadn't even finished the first one. But in this chapter, it was talking about how to deal with resentment. And I'm reading this chapter like, Lord, I've dealt with all of this stuff. You know, I was literally reading this chapter. Wow. I was reading this chapter and believing like, oh, wow, God, like, I'm really good. Like, I've gotten over the people hurt. I've gotten over, you know, daddy hurt. I've gotten over hurt between old friends. I've gotten over all these things, like dealing with people. But then I get into church and I'm trying to get into worship and I just wasn't feeling it. Like, even I was like walking around my house, disgusted, anger, like all of these things, all of these different emotions, but I had no reason to. And me and my friend were just talking about this yesterday. She texted me and we were just having this conversation about like, life is good. So why are we bugging? Like, everything literally is good. Like, there is no, I have no reason to complain. I literally have no reason to complain. Like, what's really good with me? And like, my relationships are good. Friendships are good. I'm doing what God has called me to do. I'm walking in authority. I'm doing all these things, but I'm like, what's really up? And so when he showed me that, I mean, I was in church crying most of the service because I was just shedding all of that dead weight. It says in the word, lay aside every sin and burden or heavy weight that so, I think this after so easily ensnares you, so easily entangles you. I want to make sure I said that right. But lay aside every sin and weight. And sometimes brokenness is such a weight that we carry and we don't realize that we're carrying around this brokenness, and we're trying to move forward in Christ and we're trying to be transformed and made new. And the thing that Pastor Darius was talking about is that we don't want to become faster caterpillars. I cannot remember the exact words that he was saying, but he was just saying how we want to be completely transformed, not a faster version of our old self. We want to be completely made new. So my prayer today was that, Lord, thank you for ridding me of that weight, that stronghold that was keeping me from believing you on another level. Thank you for revealing what was keeping me from believing you on the level that it was needed to believe for what's to come. Because I'm believing God for such big, grand things that are beyond me, but they're nothing to God. But there was a hindrance. And it made me think of, and someone mentioned this in service yesterday, it made me think of Daniel when he was so tired. He was eating. He didn't eat for 21 days. Some say he fasted because he was just trying to understand and get this revelation and this breakthrough of, Lord, I prayed and it still hasn't happened yet. And then the archangel Michael had to tell him, like, God heard you the first time, but we had to fight through some strongholds. We had to fight through some brokenness. We had to fight through some of your unbelief. We had to fight through some of your doubt. These are the strongholds, the barriers that cannot allow God to break through. He has to break through all of this emotional pain, all of this emotional trauma, all of this resentment towards people, him, or whatever it is, to get you to your blessing, to get the blessing to you. Because God heard you the first time. I promise you, he heard you the first time, but there are some things that are unaddressed. So I urge you today, or whenever you see this video, to sit with God and ask him, Lord, reveal to me what it is that I'm dealing with in the area of unbelief. Or what am I dealing with? Am I resenting you for something that I didn't have, that didn't happen? Is my faith not where it needs to be? Is my faith broken? Is my hope broken? Is my belief in you broken? I want to believe, but help my unbelief. Reveal to me, Father, I pray that you reveal to your children what they need to overcome, what they need to give to you, what they need to lay at the altar. Because sometimes overcoming means just laying it down and not picking it back up. It doesn't mean trying to fight your way out of it, because this thing we cannot fight through. That feeling of resentment, resenting the Almighty God, the one who created us, the one who made us, the one who set us free, that takes a spiritual exchange, a spiritual repentance, a spiritual U-turn, a spiritual laying down at the altar and saying, God, even if it's in the altar of your prayer room, the altar of your bedroom, wherever you lay down. It doesn't always have to be in the church service, but it could be in your car when you're praising the Lord. Lay down the brokenness, lay down the hurt, lay down the resentment, lay down the fear of what's to come, and give it to God and watch him completely transform your belief, even if it's painful. That's what I said. Even if it's painful to lay it down, even if it's painful to even believe again, just trust and believe that he who began a good work in you will see it to the day, coming day of Jesus Christ. He will make sure that you are complete. He will make sure your promise is complete. But he heard you the first time. He didn't miss out on what you prayed for. He understands wholeheartedly what you need, but he also knows that you need to lay some of this brokenness down and allow him to open your eyes. Because I didn't think I had. I'm like, I'm good. So when we're in prayer service, with this service yesterday was a complete outpour service, and it was just worship and prayer, and it was so needed. It was so needed. And I thank God for my pastors, because it was just so needed. And I didn't even know I needed it. I walked into church, and sometimes we can walk in with this arrogance, thinking that we're good, or like, Lord, I don't need this. I'm still going to praise. I'm still believe you for this, and that third. I went to the altar for another reason. But God was like, let me show you why you're really here. Let me open your eyes to show you why you're really here. So allow God, give him permission. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Oh my gosh. Give him permission Give him the go ahead. Give him the thumbs up. God sometimes needs our permission to have his way in our lives. But if we're closed off and we don't know it, if our hearts are closed and we don't know it, if our hearts are cold and we don't even know it, how can he penetrate it? How can he get to us what he's trying to get to us? So I urge you to give God permission to open you up, give you open heart surgery, and reveal your true nature. Reveal what you are resisting. Reveal what you are holding close to you, what hurts you are holding, what unmet expectations that you have held up. I pray that he reveals those things. But y'all, that's all I have for today. I just wanted to address that because I thought that was just too good not to share. And if you get a chance, check out the free preview of my e-course, Uncovering Patterns That Prophesy. It deals with all of the mind battles that I have faced and I still face sometimes, but the Lord has given me the tools to help someone else overcome and help myself as well, because I still use these tools every day, y'all. Like, this journey is continual, it doesn't stop. But I pray that once you get these tools in your tool belt, you can use these everywhere you go. Continue on through your journey where you're going from levels to levels, from glory to glory. But y'all, I will catch you guys on the next video. Bye.